If you want to improve your soaring skills quickly, there is no better way than to spend a few hours being instructed by one of the sport's most talented pilots. My new DVD, Soaring Masterclass 1, features Mike Smith, a U.S. National Soaring Champion with 25 years of competition experience. Mike is a natural teacher who explains complicated techniques in an easy-to-understand style you can easily relate to. Detailed diagrams and actual flight demos help you quickly visualize each tutorial. Mike teaches you his techniques for radio setups and glider optimization that will help you get your plane to fly at peak performance with less pilot workload. Other subjects covered are winch launching, perfecting zoom launches, thermaling and trim technique, launching and thermaling in strong winds, contest landing techniques, and much more. With nearly 2 hours of content, this DVD will inspire you to improve and polish your skills no matter what kind of soaring machine you fly. All of our training films have a no questions asked, money back guarantee, so you can try this fantastic instructional DVD risk-free. Purchase this DVD online at www.radiocarbonart.com or through our many authorized dealers worldwide. Here is a quick preview from the Soaring Masterclass DVD with Mike Smith.
The idea here is when you throw the airplane, if there is no winch attached, you want it to be able to come out of your hand flying. And if you throw it up like this, it's going to fly for about 3 feet and then it's going to go boom. So ideally you want to build tension, throw the airplane hard and level, hard and wings level, with no twist. You don't want to have any twist in your throw, and throw that javelin out at about a 15 to 20 degree angle, and that'll give your pilot a really good chance at a decent launch. From that point, what you're looking for is you're looking for the model to rotate on its own to a stable position on line that is slightly less than exactly 90 degrees to the line. I say that because if you're at 90 degrees or beyond, it's a very unstable configuration. You'll either pop off, snap roll, or various other things that happen with that unstable condition. So ideally you're about at an 80 degree angle. Your line's at an 80 degree angle to your fuselage and you're gonna stay on all the way up. And you're just flying all the way up the line to a point where you're about 60% down the winch line from the winch to the turnaround. At that point, you have an angle on the line of about 60 degrees. So 90, 60, 30, zero. About 60 degrees from the turnaround is your ideal high point on the launch. From there, you want to rotate, get rid of your launch camber, go to reflex at the same time, all simultaneously. Launch camber, reflex. And you're coming exactly right down the line at this point, or as close to it as you can, for as long as the spring tension is held in the line, and that varies. Monofilament, you'll have maybe a second worth of tension. Braided nylon line, half second, quarter second, just a blip. All that stretch will be gone in a heartbeat and you'll be just diving, the line will be gone and past you.